So a lot of us like to use these little USB thumb drives to store files outside of your Mac. They're useful when you want to get some files off of your Mac, to archive things, to transfer things between Macs, to bring things with you when you travel. But the problem is they're easy to lose. And when you lose them, somebody else could pick them up and access all the data on your drive. So you want to make sure you don't store anything sensitive on there, but even if you don't, you still don't want somebody going through whatever you've got on there. However, there's a way to encrypt these very easily in macOS Sierra. Now I'm going to plug this in and it should appear in the Finder on the left sidebar. There it is. I can select it. I see I've got an example file in there. Now this is completely unencrypted. Anybody sticking this in any other Mac is going to be able to see this file and all files there and read it. But you can encrypt it pretty easily. The trick is to control click on the icon there in the left sidebar, and an option is called Encrypt My Drive. Now if you see this drive on the desktop, you can control click there as well, or if you were to go to the computer level and I could see there's my drive, and I can control click there and I can also see Encrypt. You won't find it though anywhere here in the menu bar. So if you select it and look for Encrypt in the menu bar, you won't find it. So control clicking, bringing up the context menu, is critical for this. Then you select Encrypt Drive, you come up with a password, and you verify it. Now it's very important that you remember this password, because this is not a locked door kind of situation where this is locking the door and you need a password to get through. This is actually taking all the data on the drive, encrypting it using this key. So in other words, the data is no longer readable unless you have this key to actually decrypt the entire drive. So you want to include a password hint if you can. Something that of course won't give it away to just anybody but will help you remember what it is. And then you also want to add this to your password manager if you use something like 1Password or LastPass, or write it down somewhere. Because if you forget this password, you will never be able to get the data on this drive. There's no way to break the encryption short of doing some really high level stuff. So for most people it's impossible. So you want to make sure you remember the password. So you know, you just type whatever in here, my hint, that will help you. And then you hit Encrypt Disk. And the speed at which it encrypts the disk depends upon how much data you've got on it. So if you have a whole bunch of stuff on it, it's going to take a while. But in this case, it should be fairly quick because it's just that little text file. So when the process is done, you actually would see the drive disappear and reappear again. And you can select it and you can see the stuff in it right there. If I control click on it and I get info, I can see in here that it is encrypted. If you look under Mac Format, macOS Extended Journaled Encrypted. Now let's eject it, and when I insert it again I will have to enter in the password. So I've got it out. Now I'm going to attach it, and it's going to come up and ask for the password. Now I can, to this point, say remember the password in my keychain. So on this Mac I will never have to enter that password again. And this works fine because the idea is if you lose it, somebody's not going to also have your Mac to be able to enter it in. You can also hit the Show Hint to see the hint there. You hit Unlock and it will unlock the drive, and then from that point on you can use it as normal. So it's only this one time that you have to enter it in every time you add the drive to your machine. So now it appears on my left sidebar. I can click on it and access my files. Now it's important to realize that I can change this file, I can add new files, delete files, I can use the drive as normal. Anything I add to the drive now will be encrypted in the process of just simply adding it to the drive. I don't have to do anything special. So now I can use this drive as normal, but the only person that can get to the contents of the drive is me.